It seems like only yesterday you were just a child at play. Life is brief.
You might like that one.
But when it's gone, love goes on and on.
Geico has been offering savings for over 85 years. That's longer than the buffalo wing's been around. Lips are burning.
Thousands of live events.
Welcome to Missouri Valley Conference Basketball. Tonight, from Carver Arena in Peoria, Illinois, we have the Bradley Braves hosting the Illinois State Redbirds in the renewal of the I-74 series. A very pleasant good evening, everybody. Along with David Kaplan, I'm John Rooney. It's great to have you with us tonight. And I like the buildup for these games, Cappy. We have an Illinois State team that is trying to feel its way in under a new coach, while Brian Wardle's team is trying to bounce back after a 17-game home court winning streak was snapped on Saturday.
Right, they just couldn't make some shots down the stretch in a 78-76 loss to Belmont. Illinois State comes in after losing tough against Valpo. They have got to hit the court and immediately be ready for this rivalry, because Bradley's going to come out, try and punch him in the mouth.
Well, let's focus on a couple of our key players in the game tonight, beginning with Darius Burford for Illinois State.
Right, a transfer comes in. He is one of their best players. He'll give you a little over 11 a game. He had 23 the other day. Jet quick, not great from beyond the arc, 85% at the free throw line. Outstanding passer. When he gets the ball in the scoring area, he is a very tough cat to keep off the glass. Very good at rebounds, almost three a game for a point guard. Rink mast, I've been watching since he's a freshman. His footwork has just come light years. He is an outstanding presence in the paint. He'll also step out, shoots almost 30% from three, and for a big guy, that's not half bad.
Tonight's game is the 137th between Bradley and Illinois State. And since 1905, 49 games have been played, decided by 5 points or less. The I-74 series rivalry renews here tonight at Carver Arena. And we have the lineups coming up next.
Let's go.
It seems like only yesterday you were just a child at play. Life is brief.
You might like that one.
But when it's gone, love goes on and on.
Geico has been offering savings for over 85 years. That's longer than the buffalo wing's been around. Lips are burning.
Geico, over 85 years of savings and service.
Saturday primetime and Sunday showcase on ABC.
The Missouri Valley Game of the Week is brought to you by State Farm. for your personal price plan, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By Great Southern Bank, understanding what really matters. By farmer-owned Prairie Farms, drink local with Prairie Farms. And by Grinnell Mutual Insurance, trust in tomorrow. Missouri Valley Conference basketball tonight from Peoria, Illinois. We have the Bradley Braves and the Illinois State Redbirds at Carver Arena. Along with David Kaplan, I'm John Rooney. And we'll check out our keys to the game, a production of ExploreSt.Louis.com. How about it, Cappy?
Well, you take a look for Illinois State. You got to meet this rivalry head on. This is Coach Pete's first opportunity in this rivalry. And then you got to score in the 70s. When they get the score in the 70s, they're a pretty good basketball team. For Bradley, tough loss at home. From the jump, you've got to make Illinois State uncomfortable. And then you got to make the extra pass to get the open look. You got to knock him down. They didn't do that down the stretch on Saturday.
The Valley is making its way to St. Louis for Arch Madness 2023 on March the 2nd through the 5th. So start planning right now at ExploreSt.Louis.com. And let's check out our starting lineups, a presentation of Grinnell Mutual Insurance. Trust in tomorrow. And for Illinois State, it's the 10th different starting lineup this season for Coach Ryan Peden. And he's looking for a combination, something that works, that he can get some offense going and keep the effort strong and keep attacking. And they've been able to do that fairly well on the road. And for Bradley, it's Jashawn Henry making his second start this season. 924 career points, starting in place of Darius Hanna. And with this starting lineup change, it just might give Brian Wardle a chance to find better resting points for Rink Mast.
Well, they're a very good defensive team in field goal percentage defense. The thing they cannot do is let Illinois State get going from three-point land. And then Illinois State's fourth best free throw shooting team in America. You cannot put them on the line, or that could be a big problem.
And we have our renewal of Illinois State and the Bradley Braves. Always a nice atmosphere in the building, whether it's here or over in Normal. And throwback uniforms for Bradley going back to the Hersey Hawkins days. And the logo on the black jerseys for Illinois State go back to the 60s and 70s.
Yeah, I coached against those jerseys in this building. We lost. The late Dick Versace had a heck of a team.
On the attack, Bradley coming off a loss over the weekend, 78-76 to Belmont in this building, breaking a 17-game home winning streak.
They want to get the ball inside to Rink Mast as quickly as they can.
Henry muscling one in. In the starting lineup for the second time this season, Jashawn Henry averages 9.9 a game, and he puts Bradley on the scoreboard.
Well, he's got a little bounce getting that start, as you said, excited. See him, he's aggressive defensively. Getting that first basket relaxes him.
Illinois State on offense. Seneca Knight making the start. Loose ball, and in the scramble, here comes Bradley. Number 10 is Connor Hickman. Dean. And that will send Rink Mast to the free throw line. He'll be shooting two.
Well,
closed captioning for tonight's game is made possible by College Hunks Hauling, Junk, and Moving St. Louis, which provides St. Louis stress-free moving and junk removal services. Liam McChesney with his first foul puts Mast on the line. And he has another one coming up. Mast, an 83% free throw shooter.
I've been watching Rink Mast since he was a freshman. His footwork has come so far from where he was as a freshman to where he is today. His touch around the rim. He's a very, very good basketball player.
Illinois State with the basketball down 3-0 as Mast goes 1-for-2 from the free throw line. Malachi Poindexter, number one for Illinois State. We talked about Burford. He wears number 10. Number three, Knight, making the start. Off the fake. And the jumper rattles in and out for Poindexter. He had the shot, Cappy.
He did, and it was halfway down.
A shot for three. And that's no good for Duke Dean. Burford working on Connor Hickman. And nice rebound position inside for Rink Mass.
Yeah, he does a really good job. Burford got a pretty good look. He's good with that runner.
Oh, the missed dunk by Jashawn Henry.
We've got a whistle. I think Henry might have got hit in the head.
And Henry walking slowly to center court. Now, Henry missed 17 of the last 19 games last season with a head injury that was suffered on December the 18th.
Well, let's take a look how he got hit. That's the last thing he wanted to have happen.
Henry goes to the bench. Zeke Montgomery, number three in the lineup.
There's where he got hit on the back end of that.
Mast backing in, and he lost a grip on the ball, but the hook shot. And we have a whistle stopping play. Double dribble. Turnover. Illinois State's ball. Ryan Peden. First season as the coach of the Redbirds, an 8-13 record, and a long, long time assistant coach. Ohio State, Miami of Ohio, Kent State, Toledo, Illinois, and Butler.
22 years in the college game.
Now a head coach with the Illinois State Redbirds. Poindexter looking inside. Good hands on defense, and the Braves come away with the ball. Zeke Montgomery. Dean drawing some pressure. Hickman stepping up, and Dean on the outside. Nice catch there by Mast, and a foul on Mast. His first. That gives the ball back to Illinois State. Just down by three. It's 16:57 to go in the first half.
See, Bradley's had an opportunity to build on this lead early. Get a look at Brian Wardle. Eighth season as the Bradley Braves head coach. You and I both called his games when he was a player at Marquette. That guy could play.
He was the leading scorer for Tom Crean's team while in Milwaukee. And just one game under 500 with his Bradley program in his eighth season. In heavy traffic, in some trouble. And the shot just won't go down for Seneca Knight. They keep the ball alive, and the Redbirds step up, and the lay-in goes.
That was an outstanding pass by Darius Burford. Great cut along the baseline. Tough shot to complete, but the pass is what set everything up.
And Lewis scored the points. He's averaging 9-8 a game. Frank Mast with the catch, and he was met. The resistance cost Kazuki a foul, his first. Let's go back to that passing from the assist a moment ago.
And watch Burford with a really nice feed. Here he makes the move into the lane. Good jump stop, no travel. And there's the dish. Not an easy basket to complete with Rink Mast right next to you, but the pass set the whole deal up.
Mast is covered well. From the outside, Montgomery is short. The rebound by Kazuki. Kazuki out of Chaminade High School in St. Louis and came here by way of Kansas State. Seneca Knight looking for the pick by Lewis. Knight is able to get a step inside, but was denied. The shot stays with it and scores.
It looked like a three-point opportunity. A lot of contact. I like that, you know, rivalry game, the officials are letting them play.
And on the other end, a missed shot by Hickman. That belongs to Illinois State. Knight using up the dribble with lots of time on the shot clock. Malachi Poindexter. He's guarded by Leon.
Great pass.
On the cut, how about it? And the basket for Burford, his first.
that pass again. You got penetration, outstanding bounce pass. This time the shot much easier to complete.
And the layup goes for Zeke Montgomery. Boy, he found the seam and he was uncontested all the way to the rim.
We call that unfettered access to the backcourt.
Is that what you call it?
Yes. Yeah. We would tell our players. You've given them unfettered access.
And how about the shot by Knight?
Rise up, bury a three, and Illinois State off to a 9-5 lead. Bradley had opportunities to get off to a really good start and couldn't make shots.
That was a problem at the end of the game against Belmont. Short shot by Mass, but he stays with it.
Banging the offensive glass. They've got a strength and size advantage with Rink Mast.
Now, Mast was out the 2019-2020 season with a knee injury. That they worry sometimes that he gets a little fatigued late in games now. But he gives it everything he has anytime he's out there. And how about that move to the basket? But Leon's missed the close-in shot. And here's Knight taking the ball the other way. Illinois State up by a 9-7 score at 13:52 and counting in the first half. The pass inside, and the ball is controlled by Lewis. Oh, for a moment, then he lost the handle. That's a short shot for three, but he can make that shot.
I told you in the open, he shoots 29% from beyond the arc. He will take that shot. He just didn't really step into it. I thought he caught it. So I'm open, I'll shoot it. Got to get your legs into the shot.
Bradley has four steals already in this game. And that's something they're known for in the Missouri Valley Conference. Playing that kind of defense and denying the opponent. With three on the shot clock, that goes down for Seneca Knight. Knight getting the start, averages 10-6 a game and has scored seven in the first half. The Redbirds are up by four on the road here in Peoria. Mast inside, he's open, and he funnels that one in. Five for Mast in the first half.
Outstanding seal by Rink Mast. Put the big paw up, get me the basketball, and that the shot wasn't the difficult thing. It's getting that seal with the defender on your back.
And then he closed the deal.
Yes, he did. Get the seal, close the deal.
Poindexter with 12 on the shot clock. He takes the shot off the glass, and that was too strong. Duke Dean in the front court. Way outside. Dean with a long three. He shoots 37% behind the arc. And Bradley is up by a point now.
Need more movement. I think Ryan Peden's going to tell his team, guys, we need more offensive movement.
We have played past the 16-minute point in the media timeout. And that hasn't stopped both of these teams. And another steal for the Bradley Braves. Dean trying to give it back for a lay-in. Lost the ball to Illinois State. Long outside shot and a foul. 3 points. The attempt. Three free throws coming up after we have our timeout. But we're off and running in this I-74 series. Good passing. Good penetration. Good ball game to this point. 12-11, Bradley.
Everyone gets a BK stacker.
Tiny dancer.
Two linebackers.
To each their own. Burger, swagger, satisfaction buffet.
And BK, have it your way.
Kids are so expensive, Dad. Now Katie needs braces.
Maybe try switching your car insurance to Progressive. You can save hundreds.
I don't know, Dad.
Maybe try switching your car insurance to Progressive. You could save hundreds.
It's a great idea, TV Dad.
But I said the exact same thing.
Someday when you're a father, you'll understand.
I'm his father.
It's not a competition.
Listen to your TV Dad. Drivers who switch and save with Progressive save nearly $700 on average.
What's up, Einstein?
My network has gone kaput.
You tried to save a buck on it.
Not so smart.
There is a smarter way to save.
Now is the last chance to switch and get the new Samsung Galaxy S23 Plus watch and tablet on us. Don't wait. Visit Verizon today.
You remembered her favorite binky, right?
I forgot the binky.
Kia.
movement that inspires.
Let's go to the swings.
Mom, look, a clown.
Ocean Spray can make a juice drink with only 1 gram of sugar and still keep all of that powerful flavor. Then I can do anything. I can overcome my fear of clowns.
Well, hello there. Ah!
What will you do with all that power?
I'm light as a feather, I'm light as a feather, yeah, baby, I flow. It's hard to look at my resume and not find a reason to toast. I'm counting my blessings, we ain't stressing, just look at this glow.
Saturday Primetime and Sunday Showcase on ABC.
Off and running here in Peoria, Illinois. A 1-point lead for the home team, Bradley Braves. As we check out tonight's MVC men's basketball standings, the conference closes the first half of its 20-game league schedule, turning the corner now to that second half. SIU leading at 9-2, Belmont 8-3, Northern Iowa with 7 wins, Missouri State and Drake at 7 wins. Bradley looking for its 7th win, and down the line, Illinois State is after its 4th win in the league. But so far, Bradley has 5 steals, Cappy, and only 1 point off of those steals. So they're doing their job, what they're known for, but they're not converting.
They're not finishing. We saw Leones go to the basket on a layup, miss that layup. We saw open opportunities. They had a chance early to get themselves rolling and get a fairly comfortable lead early, and they couldn't make the shots. Right now, shooting just 41%. From beyond the arc, from the floor, 1 of 4 from beyond the arc.
Luke Kazuki makes his 2nd free throw. He was fouled in the act of shooting a 3-ball, so he has 1 more coming up here. And this is something that Illinois State does very well, 80% from the free throw line.
4th in the country, how about that?
And 2 out of 3 for Kazuki. So it's Bradley's ball. Illinois State by 1.
Wait till I tell you the stat about Malachi Poindexter at the line. I don't want to jinx it yet.
From the ball fake to the drive, the spin, and the layup. How about that? Malachi Leons. And he'll be on the line when we come back from a break, as he was fouled by Aruna Sissoko. Back and forth we go. Bradley back up by 1. Stay with us.
Arts. Everyone gets a BK stacker.
Tiny dancer.
2 linebackers.
To each their own. Burger, swagger, satisfaction buffet.
BK, have it your way.
Kids are so expensive, Dad. Now Katie needs braces.
Maybe try switching your car insurance to Progressive. You could save hundreds.
I don't know, Dad.
Maybe try switching your car insurance to Progressive. You could save hundreds.
It's a great idea, TV Dad.
But I said the exact same thing.
Someday when you're a father, you'll understand.
I'm his father.
It's not a competition.
Listen to your TV Dad. Drivers who switch and save with Progressive save nearly $700 on average.
What's up, Einstein?
My network has gone kaput.
You tried to save a buck on it.
I got what I paid for. Not so smart.
There is a smarter way to save.
Oh.
Switch to Verizon. You'll get a new 5G phone on them.
Act now for your last chance to get the new Samsung Galaxy S23 Plus, a watch and a tablet on us. That's a value of up to $1,900.
Oh, I love that math. I'm switching.
Now is the last chance to switch and get the new Samsung Galaxy S23 Plus watch and tablet on us. Don't wait. Visit Verizon today.
Mr. Clark, your daughter is a very good kisser.
When you crave the uncomfortable, try new.
Yeah, it rocks. Step up to GMC with 2.9% APR for 5 years and no monthly payments for 90 days on Sierra light duty models.
See. Bradley has scored 10 points in the paint, leading 14-13 over Illinois State in the first half. As we check out tonight's Birdwatch, presented by Great Southern Bank, understanding what really matters. And three terrific candidates, Ben Shepherd from Belmont, Marcus Damask from SIU, and Rink Mast on the floor tonight for Bradley.
Three outstanding players. Ben Shepherd can shoot the basketball. First of all, Belmont plays that up-tempo style. They just won at Bradley 78-76. He shoots over 42% from beyond the arc. That's tough to defend.
Great Southern Bank in the Valley, proud to recognize the league's player of the year with the Larry Bird Trophy. And on the line, shooting for a three-point play. Boy, Leon's had some move to get two and finishes off with the free throw.
How about the 137th meeting? You and I have done about 100 of them.
It feels like it, doesn't it? But they're great.
I have both ends.
And we have an over and back. Boy, Bradley put some pressure on. That's one thing they do and do very well.
So Bradley has the highest net ranking of any team in the MVC. That's what the NCAA uses as part of the selection process to the tournament. And they're also number one MVC team in the KenPom rankings, which is another metric. They are a really good team defensively.
Here's Henry feeding low for Hannah. Henry with the assist, and Darius Hannah gets his first field goal.
Beautiful cut by Hannah. He's the one that passed it to Henry, and then little delay, boom, along the baseline, gets the reverse layup to drop.
I'm glad to see Henry back out on the floor.
Yes. Getting hit in the head and being sidelined before with a head injury.
Poindexter. Burford. A lob for a catch in the corner that could not be made. Let's go back to the cut we saw a moment ago. That was sensational.
Yeah, watch this. This is what sets it all up. He delays. Now as soon as he sees the secondary defender slide into the paint, bam, there I go. There's the feed, there's the layup. Well executed.
And the shot is short. Henry, good position on the rebound and the putback.
He is a monster inside.
Oh, he didn't get the basket. The foul was on the floor.
I would like to see the NBA continuation rule be brought to this level. They're such good athletes. I would love that if they would bring it in.
Sissoko committed his second foul before Henry could get the shot away. So Bradley will play it in with 10-20 and counting in the first half. Duke Dean. Henry at the point, 10 on the shot clock.
Tom Vinen, who is one of those glue guys. He can play inside, he can step out, knock down threes, just a little short on that shot.
And that shot goes from just to the right of the lane.
Darius Burford again.
Give him four for the first half.
Came from Elon.
Ville Tavanina scored the last two for Bradley. Tavanina wearing number 23 on the outside, and Henry just muscles his way in for the basket.
Okay, now look at his shoulders. He looks like a linebacker. Do you see how he overpowers the defender, but he does it under control?
Well, that's power and quickness at its best.
Big time.
Knight has scored seven with four rebounds in the first half, just off to the right. And the ball goes out of bounds and will stay with Illinois State.
Watch the mismatch inside. This is just a guy making a play. That's just a man making a play. He's been around this league a long time. You just can't stop it. He doesn't lower his shoulder. He doesn't commit a foul. He just overpowers you.
And on the inside, nice position for the basket by Lewis. He has four in the first half. Two-hand pass to the corner. Henry stepping up. He scores.
Again, so physical. And that was not a charge. People were looking for the charge. It was not. Take a look at the bucket. Here he comes, a little spin. That is not a charge. Get the defender in the air. The greatest, most underutilized weapon, John Rooney, is the head and shoulder fake. There's your head and shoulder fake. Power it up.
We have a flop call.
Trying to take the charge.
Kelly Self is talking about that right now, and they're checking the video right now, but just mentioned something to the scores table about a flop call, something that has been a point of emphasis this season in college basketball.
So we have a flop technical, and they're trying to make sure they got the foul after the flop correct.
Colton Sandage is called for the flop.
There's the, I don't know if that's what I would characterize as a flop. There was some contact. It was not a charge. Would I call that a flop? Probably not. It was a three-point play opportunity.
So Sandage is called for the flop. Tavanainen with the miss. He's a 90% free throw shooter. And to the line, number 22, Jashaun Henry.
So Sandage, he's 6'2". He's a fifth-year senior. He's 190, strong, tough kid. Jashaun Henry now, that's a tough dude to try and guard. That is a man playing down there.
And it was Hannah making the free throw. But Jashaun Henry with 6 points in the first half. And a starting assignment, his second of the season for Coach Brian Wardle. Now for Illinois State, 22-17 Bradley at home. Burford trying to make something happen. Oh, can't quite get the bounce.
But a really good job by Bradley. A secondary defender slides over, made the shot much more difficult.
From the corner, the missed three by Connor Hickman, the sophomore out of Bloomington, Indiana. Kazuki with the ball, running the offense for Illinois State, coming down to 8 minutes to go in the first half. Burford has scored four in the first half for Illinois State. And a foul call on the drive in by Luke Kazuki.
Yeah, they're going to get Hickman reaching in. Got Arnold.
Hickman with his first foul sends us to a break at 7:52 left of the first half with Bradley on top in this one.
Back for another flounder fish sandwich?
And a shrimp tackle box.
Let us do the fishing while y'all enjoy our seafood that you'll love. Get them before they're gone.
I just got the new Samsung Galaxy S23 Ultra from U.S. Cellular. With nightography, it can take selfies in low light. Click.
Amazing. Can it go back in the bag?
Yeah, it can go back in the bag.
Okay.
The new Samsung Galaxy S23, free for everyone from U.S. Cellular.
Don't worry. It happens to the best of us.
It does?
It happens to surgeons, judges.
Overruled.
Airport Grand Crew. Game show contestants.
Bermuda Triangle.
Megan Trainor. Bowlers. It even happened to your little cousin Timmy.
That doesn't even make sense.
That doesn't matter.
Thanks, Grandpa.
What causes sensitive teeth? Did you know that the two leading causes are irritated gums and weak enamel? Switch to new Sensodyne Sensitivity Gum and Enamel. Helps take care of three problems in just one toothpaste.
Chevy Silverado factory lifted trucks. With the capability of a 2-inch lift, the versatility of the available multi-flex tailgate, and the connection of a 13.4-inch diagonal touchscreen. Chevy Silverado, taking adventure to a whole new level.
It's 22-17 Bradley. 7:52 left in the first half here in the Valley. And the Missouri Valley Conference is celebrating the 50th anniversary of the passage of Title IX legislation. Throughout the academic year, the Valley is honoring pioneers from the league's institutions who paved the way for current and future student athletes. To learn more about the conference's Title IX recognition plans, visit nbc-sports.com/Title950. That's nbc-sports.com/Title950.
So, John, Bradley leads the Valley in rebounding margin.
Yes. They're
number one, plus 4.4 over everybody else. Illinois State is five better in the rebounding end of things so far here with 7:52 to go. That is a big stat to watch because that can keep Illinois State in the ballgame. Absolutely. 16 of Bradley's 22 points in the paint.
And two more free throws for Luke Kazubki. He's 4 out of 5 from the line. An 80% free throw shooter for Illinois State. Just down by 3. So they're looking for a big stop here at 7:43 and counting. And a foul with the movement by Duke Dean toward the lane. And that's on Darius Burford, his second foul. 16 fouls for Illinois State. The next one will put Bradley on the line for a 1-1. And one of the things that Ryan Peden wants his team to do, stay engaged, stay in the game, try to look for that consistent effort. And you hang around on the home floor of a team in the Valley, you just might have a good shot at pulling an upset in the end.
You and I got to spend some time with him.
Oh, there's Henry. What great position inside.
Not going to stop him. You and I got to spend some time with Ryan. And I think you asked him a really interesting question about what is it like being a head coach after 22 years as an assistant. And he said, oh, man, your spread's so thin, it's different. He was the offensive coordinator at Ohio State.
Free throws coming up. Kendall Lewis with the fake, tried to get the basket, and one, he'll be on the line.
So he said, look, at Ohio State, I handled recruiting, of course. Every assistant does. But he said, I was the offensive coordinator. I handled my position group and the offense. I didn't have to worry about other stuff. Here, academic advisor, the nutritionist, the strength coach, oh, the AD wants to see you. Oh, guess what? You have a booster meeting. You got your recruiting.
And you're the counselor for the players.
Absolutely.
Because they're human beings, right?
Correct. And you still have to make all your recruiting visits and calls. It is a different animal to be a head coach.
Dean dishing low, looking for Henry, but stepping in the way. And back the other way now for Illinois State. Poindexter at the point.
Transfer out of Virginia.
Mizuki looking for that step, and he was pushed. Duke Dean, his first foul, the 15th foul on Bradley in the first half with 6:43 to go here in the first half of play. Illinois State to inbound from the sideline. And a three-point ball game, a chance to tie it up with a three ball here. Poindexter looking for Knight. Zuki looking low, and a foul called, a hold on Darius Hanna. That's his second foul.
That is a very good call. If you take a look at it again, he did not allow freedom of movement. Got to be able to enter the ball into the post. There he is on the side, and there's a hold. You could see his right arm wrapped around the left arm. That is as easy a call as you're going to find. Good job by the official right there.
Brink Mass back in for Bradley, replacing Darius Hanna. Hanna has two fouls. And the foul was on the floor, so the ball will be inbounded. 20 on the shot clock. And Kazubki taking the long outside pass, watched by Rink Mass. Kazubki shooting for three, count it! He had just enough space to get that one away.
Did over big Rink Mass, and they are 2 of 2 from beyond the arc. Ryan Wardle told us, we cannot allow them to shoot a high percentage from three, or that will be a problem.
Henry has scored the last 7 points for Bradley, gives it up with the pass, and there was an open look. Montgomery with the three ball. He has 5 points in the first half.
He got spotted up. Good job by Henry to get the ball to him.
27-24 Brantley. Illinois State with the ball. Poindexter drops one in. Nice short shot.
They are able to play so far downhill. We've seen a number of their guards get into the paint.
Very well said. They have. Let's take a look at the last two from beyond the arc.
This is over a 6'10" center. That is not an easy shot. They're 2 of 2 from beyond the arc. Now there's Henry. Here comes the double at him because he's been killing him inside. Kick it to the wing, open look.
Connor Hickman goes to the free throw line. We have 5:43 left in the first half. One more coming up. Hickman shoots 58% from the free throw line. They're a little bit puzzled by that because he's been shooting 35% from field goal range. They feel he's better than that, but 33% behind the arc. That's not bad.
It's not.
They feel he can do better, though, and he has been a better shooter.
Such a great rivalry.
Oh, isn't it so? Very intense first half. Stepping up along the lane, 9 on the shot clock. And we have a travel. But Bradley stands its ground so well, whether it's at the 3-point line, which they wanted to do a better job defending tonight, but especially inside.
Inside, they're outstanding. In fact, field goal percentage defense, they are number one in the conference. They're among the best teams in the country. They have got to become a better 3-point shooting team, and they must defend the three better.
Oh, the pass low, and Mast is fouled. Lewis went for the block.
This is another really, really good pass. This is Sonny Leone's flash into the middle. There's your back cut, and then there's the foul.
And on the line, Rink Mast, the junior from the Netherlands, rattling in and out.
The one thing I would say to him, when he caught that pass, the defender's there. Head and shoulder fake, get him in the air, and as he comes down, power it up through him and get yourself the basket, maybe the 3-point play.
Mast is 1 out of 4 from the free throw line tonight. Illinois State with a chance to tie with a 2-point field goal. Poindexter at the point. Oh, he lost the handle on the ball, got it back. Guarded by Connor Hickman. Hickman, a good defender. Poindexter with the turnaround. Mast, that just went over his hands, and the pass low. It's a tie-up, and here comes Bradley. Zeke Montgomery away from the pack into the front court. Leons wasn't open as he cut through the lane. Off Hickman's hand. But there's Leons.
Well, that's just catching a break. The pass was headed to Hickman. The pass got deflected and ends up right in the wing to Sonny Leones. Boom.
Leones with 5 points in the first half. Poindexter on the handoff. Seneca Knight, 7 points in the first half. Moving in on Mast. He doesn't have a shot. Poindexter is fouled.
Kyle Vinen. Watch Sonny Leons. Ball ends up in his hands in the wing. He wants to shoot it. Good little fake. Split two defenders. Finish in the lane.
Every sunrise.
Back for another flounder fish sandwich?
And a shrimp tackle box.
Let us do the fishing while y'all enjoy our seafood that you'll love. Get them before they're gone.
Kids are so expensive, Dad. Now Katie needs braces.
Maybe try switching your car insurance to Progressive. You could save hundreds.
I don't know, Dad.
Maybe try switching your car insurance to Progressive. You could save hundreds.
It's a great idea, TV Dad.
But I said the exact same thing.
Someday when you're a father, you'll understand.
I'm his father.
It's not a competition.
Listen to your TV dad. Drivers who switch and save with Progressive save nearly $700 on average.
I know what you're thinking. This all-new Nissan Ariya can't be an electric vehicle. You can't possibly be powerful and polished.
Or be able to let go.
And enjoy the open road.
Why choose?
You can have it all.
At Boar's Head, we live for delicious. For excellence that stands apart in every bite. We live for that perfect sizzle. And for perfectly melted cheese that awakens your taste buds and takes you to new heights. For experiences worth sharing and moments worth savoring. Welcome to the gateway to delicious. Welcome to the counterculture. Boar's Head. Compromise elsewhere.
With Flonase, allergies don't have to be scary. Spraying Flonase daily gives you long-lasting, non-drowsy relief. Psst, psst, Flonase, all good.
Bradley is leading the game by four here in the Valley, but looking at the boards, David Kaplan, 15 rebounds for Illinois State to Bradley's seven in the first half.
I find that stunning. Stunning to have a 15-7 lead, and Bradley is the number one rebounding differential in the league. For Illinois State to do that, to come in here, that's why we've got a heck of a ball game at 30-26.
Bradley has outscored
2 of 2 from three.
Right, and Bradley has outscored Illinois State 20-10 in the paint, but bench scoring, Bradley 7, Illinois State 6.
There you go. Haven't had a lot of fast break points.
And that's something I look at the second half of a conference schedule as they gear up, getting ready for Arch Madness, in this case for the Valley. Just what they get out of the bench.
That's the key in March. Do you have some guys that can help you?
Poindexter, another free throw coming up. He has 3 points in the first half. He's 33 for 33 from the free throw line. 34 for 34.
How about that? How about that stat?
Amazing. And so cool at the free throw line. Perfect rotation on the ball. And he's perfect from the line so far in this 22-23 season. That goes high off the back iron, and Illinois State down 30-28, a chance to tie or take the lead with this trip. A really good catch by Seneca Knight. And now he puts the move in on Zeke Montgomery and gets it off the glass.
Well, that was a really good job. The great catches you talked about, and then get himself into the paint and be able to get that bucket.
We're tied at 30. Long outside three. That is too strong and out of bounds to Illinois State. Duke, we've seen that Duke Dean can hit that outside shot, but not that time. Stay tuned for our halftime report sponsored by State Farm Insurance, a proud partner of the Missouri Valley Conference. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And Kendall Lewis will be our halftime feature as we do our Arch Madness profile. And we'll recap the game, take a look at the stats, and get you set for the second 20 minutes of play.
Like the movement we're seeing out of Illinois State. Brian Peden was talking to his team. Guys, we got to have more movement. They're paying attention.
And Kazuki all the way in. He had the opening and converted.
Bradley looks a little flat to me right now. They have not been able to make shots from beyond the arc. They just look a little disjointed offensively.
And contact inside with Hannah trying to get to the basket. And we have 1-1 coming up with the foul committed by Aruna Sissoko. That's his third.
So I thought this could have been an offensive foul. If you take a look at it, you watch the offensive player take his hand and hook the defender. I think the official was screened and didn't get to see it, but he reached out and hooked Sissoko.
And Sissoko goes over to the bench after three fouls. And missing the front end of the 1-1. Darius Hannon with a miss and back to Illinois State, leading by two. As we come down to 2 minutes left in the first half. This I-74 rivalry game between Illinois State at Bradley.
Bradley 40% from free throw line tonight. 40%.
Seneca Knight with the fadeaway. He has 11 in the first half. Illinois State up by four. Here's Hickman, and he lost the grip on the ball. Knight. He gives it up to Poindexter, clearing the timeline with a minute 34 and counting in the first half. A very good first half for the Redbirds. A neat run for them.
They were down. They were struggling with their offense. They were standing around. Ryan Peden talked during a timeout. From that timeout on, they've been pretty good.
Great anticipation. And Leon scores. He has seven. He got the steal and the basket.
They're getting some points going to the basket. I just don't see offensive flow yet and then making some jump shots. That's what Brian Wardle will talk about.
Poindexter on the handoff. Out of bounds. Nine on the shot clock with 53.1 on the game clock.
Watch the steal and the basket here. There's the turnover. Leonce gets into the passing lane, gets his hand in there. Really unselfish play. Run the court, feed the big man, let him eat.
And on the other end, Connor Hickman committed a foul, his second. And Kazuki makes another free throw. He missed his first, but has hit five in a row and has 10 points in the first half. This one's in play at 53.1 to go until halftime.
This is a team that whatever they're doing to practice free throws, Brian Peden should bottle it and sell it to coaches across the country. They're fourth in the country, and Malachi Poindexter, 34 straight to start the season.
Dean out high, watched by Poindexter. Oh, wide open inside, and that's a dunk for 35, Darius Hanna.
What an outstanding pass.
Well, there have been some great passes getting to the basket, getting to the lane.
Absolutely right. Technical foul.
Kelly Self calling the technical foul. Double technical. Alex Kotov. Kotov with his first foul. And Hannah with the foul.
A lot of chirping going on. There they are going at it. And good officiating. Kelly Self came over, that's it. Not gonna tolerate it. That's what good officials do. They get control of the basketball game.
And when the MVC TV network crews travel to campuses, it considers these properties home away from home. These hotels consistently support the conference and its 12 member institutions. Please call or visit the websites of these properties when making plans to follow your favorite team away from home in the Missouri Valley Conference. That's about the best way to handle it, Cappy. Say, all right, this is it. Now let's play on.
Correct.
And no more.
Knock it off. So you mentioned Malachi Poindexter of Illinois State, transferred from Virginia. He made two tonight. He's made 34 straight free throws, third longest free throw streak in program history behind Gene Gentry in 56-57. He had 35. The record, Vince Green, 03-04, 57 straight. Pretty good.
So here we go with Illinois State inbounding after the double technical, 20.4 seconds to go. We're in the first half. Our State Farm halftime report coming up shortly. Less than a second difference between the game clock and the shot clock. Oh, the long pass is picked off. Montgomery for the dunk. The steal and the dunk, he has seven.
Gotta take care of the ball. You gave the crowd some juice.
Poindexter was fouled with 1 second to go in the first half. Jashaun Henry with the foul, giving Poindexter three free throws.
Well, here's the steal. And that's going to lead right to a flush. You give the crowd some juice. Everybody's excited. And then here's the foul.
And a technical foul has been called on Brian Wardle.
Kelly Self was waiting. He's been watching him, and the other officials have been watching. And as soon as Brian and his assistant said something, they'd had enough. Bam.
Well, you can hear the reaction from the Bradley fans located close to our broadcast position.
Jack Watkins has a dump button.
Well, with 1 second to go until halftime, this could be a huge turning point with the three free throws and then the technical.
Correct.
Poindexter, 2 for 2 tonight, 34 out of 34 in this basketball season. There's his first miss.
That ends the run at 34. Only 18 players in the history of this amazing league have had longer streaks.
But he starts a new one. One more shot in play with 1 second to go. Well, those were the two technical free throws. Now the three. One more to go. Now this one's in play with 1 second left. So he had the two technical, and with everybody along the lane, three shots as he was fouled behind the arc. That's the way it will end the first half. 40-36, Illinois State here at Bradley. And a very consistent effort by Illinois State has them in front on the road in the Valley.
Yeah, I give them a lot of credit. Coming off a really bad loss to Valparaiso. I think Ryan Peden's got his kids playing hard. They took a little bit of a punch early when they weren't getting some shots to drop. I thought Bradley really was flat late.
Well, Bradley got 9 points from Jashaun Henry in just his second start of the season. But Seneca Knight off the bench. He started this one tonight and has scored 11. And Kazuki has 11. Straight ahead, our State Farm halftime report with Illinois State leading on the road in the Missouri Valley.
Everyone gets a BK stacker.
Tiny dancer.
Two linebackers.
To each their own. Burger, swagger, satisfaction buffet.
And BK, have it your way.
Mom, can we get a puppy, Mom?
Please?
Girls, pets are a big expense.
Maybe try switching your car insurance to Progressive. You could save hundreds.
Thanks, TV Dad. We'll think about it, okay?
Look what I found.
A puppy!
Oh, no.
I wish TV Dad was always in charge.
Listen to your TV Dad. Drivers who switch and save with Progressive save nearly $700 on average.
I know what you're thinking. This all-new Nissan Ariya can't be an electric vehicle. You can't possibly be powerful and polished.
Or be able to let go.
And enjoy the open road.
Why choose?
You can have it all.
Don't worry. It happens to the best of us.
It does?
It happens to surgeons, judges.
Overruled.
Airport ground crew. Game show contestants.
Bermuda Triangle.
Megan Trainor. Bowlers. It even happened to your little cousin Timmy.
That doesn't even make sense.
That doesn't matter.
Thanks, Grandpa.
Metro offers MLS season pass.
On us.
What about for existing customers?
Yep.
Every match?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Says it on the poster.
Get MLS season pass on us, plus unlimited 5G for $25 a line.
Giorgio, look. The peanut butter box is here.
Ralph, that's the Chewy Pharmacy box with our flea and tick meds. It's not peanut butter.
I know, but every time the box comes, we get the peanut butter.
Yes, because Mom...
Game of the Week is brought to you by State Farm. For your personal price plan, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By Great Southern Bank, understanding what really matters. By farmer-owned Prairie Farms, drink local with Prairie Farms. And by Grinnell Mutual Insurance, trust in tomorrow.
Our halftime report from Peoria, Illinois, from Carver Arena, is sponsored by State Farm Insurance, a proud partner of the Missouri Valley Conference. Visit statefarm.com or talk to your local agent to get your State Farm personal price plan. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Get a quote tonight. And our first half highlights are made possible by Live by Lowe's St. Louis. Want to experience laid-back luxury in the heart of downtown St. Louis, adjacent to Ballpark Village? Visit lowshotels.com/St. Louis. That's L-O-E-W-S, hotels.com/STLOUIS to book your hotel room right now. Let's take a look at some highlights. And the highlights favored Illinois State 40-36 in the first half. Seneca Knight making the start, part of the 10th different starting lineup for Ryan Peden.
Did a really good job banging the glass. We saw him with a really tough catch. And then here he knocks down a perimeter shot. We saw him make, as you called it, a tough catch. And then right here, spin in the lane, split two defenders, finish off the window. Thought he had a really, really impressive first half for Illinois State. And Gershon Henry's just a man. He is just a beast inside. There you see him get the post. He is just going to back you down, doesn't charge. Gets the hoop. He gets another one with the hoop and the arm in the paint. He's very, very good.
9 points with a rebound for Henry, making his second start of the season for Ryan Wardle. And Cappy in the first half, though, the rebounding story for Illinois State kept them in position where they had the halftime lead.
Right. You look at the rebounding numbers and you think 18-7. If I'm Brian Wardle, I am challenging my guys. Guys, we are number one in the league in rebound advantage. You're getting destroyed on the glass, and that is want to. You've got to want to rebound.
And Brian is also looking for some flow to his offense.
Agreed. Too much standing around. You get some opportunities, someone will put it on the deck, get to the rim, but we're not seeing anything come out of the system.
Well, what's in store for the second half? We'll be talking about that shortly. We have our halftime feature coming up. We'll go over the stats. A lot more to come on our State Farm Halftime Report after you watch these messages.
Will remain radioactive for years to come. Well, thank goodness, it's time for the good news of the week.
And boy, do we need it. Well, this safe driver saved money with the Snapshot app from Progressive. How do you feel?
Good.
He's better than good. He got rewarded for driving safe and driving less.
Sorry, Barb, just to confirm, this is the feel-good news of the week?
This is what we found.
Yay, Snapshot!
Back for another flounder fish sandwich?
And a shrimp tackle box.
Let us do the fishing while y'all enjoy our seafood that you'll love. Get them before they're gone.
Let's go. Okay,
lockdown,
go.
Bye, Sawyer. It seems like only yesterday you were just a child at play. Life is brief.
You might like that one.
But when it's gone, love goes on and on.
Can't possibly be powerful or polished
or be able to let go
and enjoy the open road.
Why choose?
You can have it all.
At Boar's Head, we live for delicious, for excellence that stands apart in every bite. We live for that perfect sizzle and for perfectly melted cheese that awakens your taste buds and takes you to new heights. For experiences worth sharing and moments worth savoring, welcome to the gateway to delicious. Welcome to the counterculture. Boar's Head. Compromise elsewhere.
Chevy Silverado factory lifted trucks. Where will they take you? With the capability of a 2-inch lift.
Sponsored by State Farm Insurance, a proud partner of the Missouri Valley Conference. Visit statefarm.com or talk to your local agent to get your State Farm personal price plan. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Get a quote tonight. It's time for tonight's profile, made possible by Arch Madness 2023. MVC correspondent Kurt Pegler takes a look at Redbirds senior forward Kendall Lewis.
Kendall Lewis isn't looking at the standings to determine if it's a successful season at Illinois State. He's looking at his teammates.
We just been having real competitive practices, and just everybody's just been connected as one, and that's the main thing Coach talking about, just the connectedness of the team. We can't come out one game and play bad and still win. We just have a team. We got to play great every game to get a dub.
Lewis is the heart and soul of the Redbirds. He played in every game last year and is hoping to do the same this season. A player who can stuff stat sheets with points, rebounds, assists, steals. He's one of the players that decided to stay in Normal after ISU made a coaching change, which led to a turnover of the Redbird roster.
It's just change, just being willing to accept change and just everything Coach say, just being able to trust him. That's building trust in Coach, him building trust in us building trust in each other, like teammates. That's just, it is a strange situation, but just all of us, we know we all in it together. So anybody could be a leader in this situation, because it's not like anybody knows more than anybody else. But of course, I'm gonna try to step up and lead as much as I can.
Lewis says he was sold on first-year coach Ryan Peden shortly after he met him. And he says his coach is keeping things positive as the Redbirds navigate through a tough Valley season.
Coach Peden's energy is very contagious. Just how since he came in, he's been on like a train. Just we going, and we either stay with him or fall behind, and none of us is fall behind.
For the Missouri Valley Conference, I'm Kurt Pegler.
Tonight's profile is made possible by the 2023 State Farm MVC Men's Basketball Tournament. Make plans to attend the inaugural 12-team event at Enterprise Center in St. Louis, March the 2nd through the 5th. For more information, visit archmadness.com. We're at halftime, Peoria, Illinois. The I-74 series between Bradley and Illinois State, with more to come after this.
Back for another flounder fish sandwich?
And a shrimp tackle box.
Let us do the fishing while y'all enjoy our seafood that you'll love. Get them before they're gone.
Yeah.
Let's go to the swings.
Mom, look, a clown.
If Ocean Spray can make a juice drink with only 1 gram of sugar and still keep all of that powerful flavor, then I can do anything. I can overcome my fear of clowns.
Well, hello there.
What will you do with all that power?
Metro offers MLS season pass.
On us.
What about for existing customers?
Yep.
Every match?
I bet, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Says it on the poster.
Get MLS season pass on us, plus unlimited 5G for $25 a line.
Everything we know is at risk. The time to act is now. We must all be champions. Champions for the Earth.
Ooh, the Chewy app. Clumping litter, salmon pate. We have enough to splurge on catnip toys. I feel so accomplished. Pet me, please.
Great prices, happy pets. Chewy.
Oh, that spin class was brutal.
Well, you can try using the PX massaging.
Insurance, a proud partner of the Missouri Valley Conference. Visit statefarm.com or talk to your local agent to get your State Farm personal price plan. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. So get a quote tonight. Now let's check out our first half stats, a production of Union Station St. Louis, the home of attractions like the St. Louis Aquarium, St. Louis Wheel. You can do it all at Union Station. To see where it takes you, visit stlouisunionstation.com. Check out the rebounds, 18-7 in favor of Illinois State. But the last Bradley rebound, Cappy, came at 8:24 left in the first half.
Right. I'm looking at that stat. 8:24 to go in the half, and you don't get another rebound. Not one.
That would, boy, I would be furious if I am Brian Wardle, and I would imagine he was.
But consider this. The Braves are down by four at halftime.
Correct.
And they have gone 4-for-10 from the free throw line, while Illinois State's a great free throw shooting team, 14 out of 16 in the first half, and Poindexter finally missed a free throw after going 34-for-34.
Right, 6-of-7 for him. Hisubi has 6-of-7 and 2-of-2 for Kendall Lewis. Gives you your 14-of-16, but the 18-to-7 rebound totals is stunning to me. Bradley's season low is 26 rebounds versus Auburn.
At the half, it's Illinois State 40, Bradley 36. Both teams are back out on the floor. That means the start of the second half is straight ahead.
Moving day.
With one of the best savings rates in America, banking with Capital One is the easiest decision in the history of decisions. Even easier than this.
Stop. You're in.
Oh, cool. Yep, even easier than that. And with no fees or minimums on checking and savings accounts, is it even a decision? That's banking reimagined. What's in your wallet?
Everyone gets a BK stacker.
Tiny dancer.
Two linebackers.
To each their own. Burger, swagger, satisfaction buffet.
And BK, have it your way.
You don't have to believe in free throw superstition for it to work. Because after this many orders on NBA game day, your local wing joint believes enough for the both of you. Support your neighborhood and your team with every DoorDash order. Same order, same time, every game day. Which means more tips for your Dasher, business for your corner store, and just maybe a superstitious boost for your team. Support your neighborhood and your team with every DoorDash order.
A ballet studio, an architecture firm, and homemade barbecue sauce. They're called small businesses, but to the people who build them, there's nothing small about them. That's why at T-Mobile for Business, you'll save more than $1,000 versus Verizon. And with Price Lock Guarantee, we'll never raise your rate plan. So you can keep your focus on toe turns and making sure the sauce is extra spicy. At T-Mobile, there are no small businesses.
Chevy Silverado factory lifted trucks, where will they take you? With the capability of a 2-inch lift, the versatility of the available multi-flex tailgate, and the connection of a third.
Of the week is brought to you by State Farm. For your personal price plan, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By Great Southern Bank, understanding what really matters. By farmer-owned Prairie Farms, drink local with Prairie Farms. And by Grinnell Mutual Insurance, trust in tomorrow. With David Kaplan, I'm John Rooney, and we're at Carver Arena, Peoria, Illinois, the home of the Bradley Braves. And Bradley, after having a 17-game home court winning streak snapped by Belmont here Saturday, trails 40-36 to Illinois State in the I-74 series. Ryan Davis is our statistician, and he's been pointing out many things. Now, you talked about what Brian Wardle may have said to his team at halftime. Well, how does Coach Ryan Peden keep this going?
He wants his guys to continue to attack the rim. When they get movement and they're not stagnant offensively, they've been able to get their guards into the paint and get some opportunities. That's going to be the key, because if you go inside out, you're going to get some open looks. They're 2-of-2 from beyond the arc.
Illinois State wearing black with numbers in red outlined in white. The Bradley Braves wearing the throwback uniforms to the days of Hersey Hawkins here at Carver Arena. And what a great scorer, great player he was. Burford with the ball on offense, and here we go in the second half. With Bradley down by four, Burford called for an offensive foul. That is his third foul. That's big right out of the gate in the second half on one of the best players for the Redbirds.
That is big. But if you're Ryan Peden, you can't take him out. He's got to be smart. He's a veteran player. He knows.
Here's Duke Dean. Mast with the give back for Dean, who gets all the way to the rim and is blocked inside. Kazuki comes away with the ball. And Liam McChesney was there on the inside to get the block and takes the long outside shot and misses. Followed his shot, got a hand on it, saved by Malachi. Malachi Poindexter kept the ball in play. And here's Kazuki going in, and he is fouled going for the dunk. Oh, wonderful hustle kept that possession alive for Illinois State.
It did, because as he comes racing toward you and I, there comes the ball. He does a really good job at looking where he's going to throw it. He gets it back in. He didn't just wing it in there. And then there's a hard foul.
There was no foul called on that. That was called just out of bounds. Looked like a hard foul to me.
Did too.
The shot with one on the shot clock. And there's Seneca Knight. Knight is blocked by Leons. But Illinois State gets the ball right back. 15 on the shot clock. Poindexter at the point, and we'll give it up to Darius Burford. Burford guarded by Duke Dean. Five on the shot clock. McChesney dumps it low, and a shot clock violation. He didn't have that time to make the extra pass.
Yeah, McChesney's got to shoot the basketball there. He knows.
He had the size, and he had the room.
He did. He had the opportunity. He just... being unselfish, you appreciate the unselfishness, but not in that situation.
Frank Mass. Here's Hickman, and he's on target. That's his first field goal. He has 3 points tonight.
This is a key 3 minute, 4 minute stretch.
And there's some of the flow that Coach Wardle was looking for.
Correct.
In the first half.
Got a curl move, got himself a good look at the basket.
With contact, Poindexter scores anyway. He has 10.
Next 3 to 4 minutes, very key for these clubs to see if somebody could separate themselves.
Poindexter with a bump, no foul called. Deshaun Henry giving it up to Hickman. Back to Henry, and a reach-in is called. A foul on the floor, and that goes against Knight, his first. Well, excuse me, that was on Burford. Here we go to our replay.
There's the really nice curl move. There's the easy basket. That is a big foul on Burford.
Four fouls, two quick ones here early in the second half.
Brian just had some words with him. Just said, we got to be smart. He's such a key player for that.
Was that ball kicked? No, no whistle.
It looked like it.
Here's Mast. Dean moving past the pick set by Mast, and we have a whistle stopping play.
There's Coach Peden right there talking with him. It's right in front of us. And he said, settle down, relax, I'll get you back in there. You got four. We got to be smart.
And we have the officials at the scorer's table taking a look at video. Looked like a kick ball a moment ago.
But I don't believe a kick, once play had resumed, is reviewable.
I don't think so. Kelly Self, Marcus Pettigrew, and Irvin Wilson are the officials assigned by the Missouri Valley Conference for our game tonight here at Bradley at Carver Arena. And we hope to get an explanation once they go through the video review. It took a while to stop play, though.
It did.
And we'll get an explanation here in just a second.
So they are trying to determine, he said, we did not call kickball.
Right.
He said, we are trying to determine, was there a shot clock violation before there was change of possession?
Well, let's see what you think, folks.
There's the, did you think that was a kick?
And then we have the stoppage in play, and they put 4 seconds up on the shot clock. So the ball belongs to Bradley with 4 on the shot clock after the video review.
He's going up. He's going up.
And that is a
foul.
Foul right at the horn. And that was on Kendall Lewis, his second.
They're going to get a body foul trying to guard Gershon Henry, who we've told you all night how physical a player he is.
Long lob out front. Malavai Leons, number 14. Hickman, entry pass to Mass. Great catch by Henry in the dunk.
Oh, rise up and set it down, big fella.
The catch was great. The shot was even better. The dunk.
The dunk was impressive. That is exploding off the floor.
Boy, that can get a team going. Bradley down by 2 now. Big trip down the floor here for Illinois State. Knight is blocked inside. And the shot for 3 goes down from the outside by McChesney.
Big fella has that ability. I've watched him over the years. He can shoot the basketball from there.
From the outside, that rims out for Dean. McChesney gets the basket and goes to the free throw line. He was going for the dunk, but then released the ball. It found the net, and he goes to the free throw line.
Every time I feel like Bradley is going to make a little bit of a run,
something like this happens.
Correct. McChesney hits the 3, McChesney here, and the crowd goes deathly silent.
One shot here for Liam McChesney.
He's rising
10 out of 12 from the line.
Gonna flush it.
I thought he was gonna try to hammer it, but then he just dropped it into the basket like dropping a waste paper into a basket.
He did, just a little doop.
The shot for the 3-point play. That rims out. Run down in the corner by Illinois State. How about that save by Sissoko?
Outstanding. Tomorrow's film session's not going to be fun for a Bradley Braves player.
Poindexter. The ball is poked out of bounds. And we'll go over to Bradley as we have a timeout with 16 minutes to go in the second half. Illinois State led by 4 at the half, up by 7 right now at Carver Arena.
Back for another flounder fish sandwich?
And a shrimp tackle box.
Let us do the fishing while y'all enjoy our seafood that you'll love. Get them before the...
Interesting piece. Let me bring in my expert.
So many scratches.
Those are from my car keys.
Such a rich history. This won't do well at auction, but at AT&T, it's worth a brand new Samsung Galaxy S23.
Wait, really?
Mm-hmm.
What about this?
AT&T's deal is back. Everyone gets a free new Samsung Galaxy S23 with a Galaxy phone traded. Any year, any condition.
You can't possibly be powerful, polished,
or be able to let go
and enjoy the open road.
Why choose?
You can have it all.
Let's go to the swings.
Mom, look, a clown.
Ocean Spray can make a juice drink with only 1 gram of sugar and still keep all of that powerful flavor. Then I can do anything. I can overcome my fear of clowns.
Well, hello there.
What will you do with all that power?
In the second half, it's Illinois State by 7 at Bradley. And tonight's State Farm MVC Scholar Athlete of the Game is Bradley's Nicola Jansen, a sophomore distance runner from South Africa. Jansen won the individual title at the 2022 MVC Cross Country Championship in Terre Haute, Indiana. A great point of 3.70 in nutrition and dietetics, Jansen was the 2021 MVC Cross Country Freshman of the Year. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
So Bradley just grabbed a rebound. That was their first rebound since the 8:24 mark of the first half. 12:24 between rebounds. They are being out-rebounded, and they're number one in the league, 26-8.
And here's Bradley with the ball after the timeout, trailing by seven, looking to get on a run. Connor Hickman, sophomore from Bloomington, Indiana, at the point. Shot for three, and Montgomery misses. Henry trying to get the loose ball. It's tied up.
Possession to Bradley.
Bradley will inbound. New 20 on the shot clock. But Henry, he is on a roll in this one, making the start tonight. 935 career points for Jashaun Henry. The inbounds pass is saved by Darius Hanna. Hanna with the left hand. Give him six.
He tried to jam that into Jashaun Henry. Hanna happened to be right there and picked up the loose change.
Poindexter on the outside with Knight. McChesney takes the pass. Fans it out for the corner. Kazuki along the baseline and the score. Lewis has eight. He was wide open.
They will give a lot of credit to Illinois State, how hard they're playing. Bradley is not playing well in any aspect right now.
The rebound for Hanna and the loose ball in the corner. And the ball is going to go back the other way to Illinois State.
Another turnover. Watch this pass along the baseline. Got to turn your head. It's called ball you man defense. Very poor job by Hanna defensively. He got spun around. All of a sudden, the pass is by him for a layup.
Here's Poindexter in the front court for Illinois State, leading by seven. Poindexter fanning it out to the corner. McChesney, no shot. Knight backing away with five on the shot clock, and a bumping foul called on Jashaun Henry, his third.
It's a good call.
Boy, one bump, two bumps, three bumps, whistle.
They're going to get you.
Seneca Knight with the inbounds pass.
Todd Vinen comes back in. He's not as strong as Jashaun Henry, but a very similar kind of player.
Poindexter at the point, looking for a pick. That was set by Lewis. 10 on the shot clock. Poindexter in on Hickman. Here is McChesney, rimming out. Connor Hickman is there for Bradley. He pushes the ball quickly into the front court. Long outside shot off the back iron. And there's Poindexter to secure the rebound for Illinois State. One and done for Bradley.
Bradley 2 of 11 from beyond the arc now.
And we have a whistle, stoppage in play with Poindexter cramping up perhaps. 19 on the shot clock, and Knight will inbound for Illinois State. Guarded by Ville Tavanaina.
See, so much more movement out of Illinois State offensively.
You don't see anybody standing around, Cappy.
You do not.
Three on the shot clock, long outside shot off the front of the rim, and McChesney is there on the sideline inside rink mast. 13, 25 and counting, and Illinois State has the ball, leading by seven. Five on the shot clock, and a steal. Leons with the steal. Hickman, the no-look pass for the corner. Leon steps up. Tried to push it inside to Mass, deflected to McChesney.
Bradley starting to press now.
I think so. Kazuki took an extra step. Turnover, Illinois State. Bradley has been able to get Illinois State to turn over the ball tonight, but the Braves aren't scoring much off those turnovers.
That was the 15th Illinois State turnover tonight. You would think you turn someone over 15 times, have a pretty good chance to win the basketball game.
Sissoko and Sandage come in. Poindexter goes out along with McChesney.
Bradley's only turned it over 5 times. But the big difference is 2 of 11 from beyond the arc. 14 of 17 for Illinois State at the line to 4 of 10.
Leon's open from the corner. That's 10 for him tonight. He averages 11-1 a game. A 4-point game, that's what it was at halftime. And Bradley applying a lot of pressure.
They'll guard you. Bradley's never gonna not guard you.
And we have a timeout called by Illinois State. Ryan Peden gets the timeout with 13 on the shot clock. And we'll take the break. Illinois State will have the ball when we come back. We have a good one. The I-74 series continues after this.
With one of the best savings rates in America, banking with Capital One is the easiest decision in the history of decisions. Even easier than this.
Stop. You're in.
Oh, cool.
Yep, even easier than that. And with no fees or minimums on checking and savings accounts, is it even a decision? That's banking reimagined. What's in your wallet?
Everyone gets a BK stacker.
Tiny dancer.
Two linebackers.
To each their own. Burger, swagger, satisfaction buffet.
BK, have it your way.
What's up, Einstein?
My network has gone kaput.
You tried to save a buck on it.
Not so smart.
There is a smarter way to save.
Now is the last chance to switch and get the new Samsung Galaxy S23 Plus watch and tablet on us. Don't wait. Visit Verizon today.
How irresistible are Cheez-It crackers?
All of my life, I've been
Cheese. No.
Come on, him.
Ooh, I like him.
No!
Quick, the quicker picker-upper. When you gotta get it done, just one sheet is all you need. Because one sheet of Bounty absorbs more than theirs, so you can use less.
He's an 8.
He's a 9.
Get the job done with one. Bounty, the quicker picker-upper.
Boy, it's 49-45 Illinois State on the road at Bradley. And let's check out tonight's Missouri Valley Conference scores and schedules. A presentation of Grinnell Mutual Insurance, trust in tomorrow. And there you have it, the second half. Northern Iowa leading at home against Valpo. And Belmont is at Evansville, leading 67-59 with 5:50 to go in the second half. Cappy, we've turned the halfway point after tonight's games in the Valley. 9 left for each team. And it seems to me, when the calendar turns to February, February goes by in a blur.
It does. It flies. It's a shorter month. The next thing you know, oh my goodness, baseball's back.
Well, and Arch Madness.
Arch Madness.
And then we get the regional tournaments. I know. It's so much fun to follow all the basketball during spring training. I can tell you that firsthand.
Arch Madness is so
two on the
fun.
Shot clock, and that is short. But the follow goes.
Another loose ball on the ground that Illinois State gets, and Bradley does not. Bradley's legs just look dead to me on the offensive end and on loose balls. I think they're locked in trying defensively.
Sissoko with his fourth personal foul. That sends us to a break at 11:49 left in the game with Illinois State on top in this one.
The Venture
Put.
You tried to save a buck on it.
Not so smart.
There is a smarter way to save.
Now is the last chance to switch and get the new Samsung Galaxy S23 Plus watch and tablet on us. Don't wait. Visit Verizon today.
Back. back for another flounder sandwich?
And a shrimp tackle box.
Let us do the fishing while y'all enjoy our seafood that you'll love. Get them before they're gone.
I know what you're thinking. This all-new Nissan Ariya can't be an electric vehicle. You can't possibly be powerful and polished. Or be able to let go. And enjoy the open road. Why choose? You can have it all.
This is how Peloton does after hours.
Are y'all excited to be here?
In the early evening with a mug of hot tea.
You're damn right.
With the one, the only, me, Cody Rigsby.
All right, y'all ready to dance? Now, friends, this is a talk show on wheels full of pop culture obsessions, celebrity confessions.
So pop, lock, and side eye, boo. This is gonna be an LOL.
Are y'all ready? Yes, that's what I'm talking about.
Oh, what entertainment we've had here at this commercial break. Outstanding at Carver Arena with Illinois State leading 51-45 over Bradley in the Valley. And we invite you to download the Arch Madness app presented by Great Southern Bank, understanding what really matters. The app has all the information you need to know about the tournament schedule, hotel accommodations, and other fun events during the tournament. Download the app right now on your Android or iOS device tonight. Now, something I don't quite understand. Ryan Davis, our statistician, handed a note to Cappy and said, keep that in your back pocket. How are you going to read that with that note in your back pocket?
X-ray vision.
Only you can do that.
Do you realize that
this was our entertainment during the
game? Oh, it was phenomenal. Ryan also told
me. Kind of tough to digest.
Very good. Ba-dum-bum. Ryan also told me that the offensive rebound Illinois State got gave them more offensive rebounds than Bradley has total rebounds in the game.
From the corner, the shot goes too long. Tavanainen with the miss, and Illinois State coming back the other way, leading 51-45 with 11:25 and counting in the second half. Seneca Knight has scored 11 points. Loose ball, and Tavanainen is picked clean by Knight. Inside, Illinois State scores the basket for Knight.
8-point game, 11:04 to go. This next 3 minutes, Bradley could be buried the way they're playing. They can't come up with a rebound. They can't make a shot. And a loose ball always seems to go to the guys wearing the black uniforms.
The biggest lead for Illinois State. The turnaround shot won't go down for Knight.
Rebound.
And a foul with Lewis trying to get to the rim. Mast with his third foul puts Kendall Lewis on the free throw line. Number 22, Kendall Lewis, with Appalachian State. He's from Georgia, a 6'8 senior, averaging 9.8 a game. He has 10. Make that 11 tonight. March Madness 2023 tips off March the 2nd through the 5th. The only place to celebrate before and after all the action at Enterprise Center is the MVC Fan Hangout at Ballpark Village. For all you need to know about the Fan Hangout, download the Arch Madness app right now. Looking for point number 12. Lewis in double figures with 12. 13 second chance points, Cappy, off 13 offensive rebounds for Illinois State.
Since the timeout, a 6-0 run for the Redbirds.
And a block inside of fouls called. That was McChesney getting his hand on the ball. But the foul is on Sandage.
Yep, correct. McChesney's looking around going, I only got all ball. It's not on you.
Nope. Montgomery at the free throw line, 57% from the line, and another miss for Bradley. Bradley as a team shoots 68% from the line.
You'd like to be in the 70s, always your goal. 68's not horrifically bad, but tonight they've been terrible and they missed 5 straight at the free throw line. Now they finally knock one down.
They had five consecutive misses from the free throw line before that one. Illinois State up 55-46, coming down to 10 minutes to go in the game. McChesney, he was eyeing the basket. With the turnaround, a foul on the shot taken by Seneca Knight.
Yeah, that's a bad call.
And that's the fourth on Jashaun Henry.
I did not like that call. I'd have to see it again, but from first blush, from where we're seated, I thought he had what's called the principle of verticality. There's his arms up. I do not think that's a foul. Absolutely not.
Register to win an Arch Madness VIP package, including all-session tickets for the State Farm MVC Men's Basketball Tournament, hotel accommodations, and tickets to St. Louis area attractions. Log on to exploreSt.Louis.com/MVC contest for complete information. Knight with the made free throw makes it a 10-point game, Illinois State. The bounce pass low, mishandled, and Illinois State comes away. McChesney, Malachi Poindexter. McChesney blocked by Darius Hanna. Here's Dean. Counter.
That's a big. You get the block at one end, you get a 3-point basket, you're able to walk into it. That's a big swing. All of a sudden, you get a stop here, and you feel like, hey, here we go.
Then you're back in it. Let's see what Illinois State has in mind. The Redbirds are up 56-49.
See how much more aggressive Bradley is defensively.
That was a pick-me-up, that last swing with the block and the three ball. From the corner. Another offensive rebound and a putback.
Just crushing him on the glass.
Kazuki.
Crushing him.
Dean. That goes off the rim and down to Luke Kazuki.
Brian Wardle's got to be stunned at what he's watching. He's run guys in and out. He's trying everything he can.
The defensive effort is there.
They're playing hard, but when there's loose balls, I'm seeing the guys from Illinois State coming up with every loose ball, every rebound.
Kazuki guarded by Mast. Open shot, right side at the buzzer on the shot clock. Knight with the miss. And we're going to have a timeout for Bradley with 8:23 to go in the second half. And we'll take our break here on the NBC TV network. We're glad you're with us tonight. Illinois State with a stunning performance on the road, and Bradley with the lead.
It's a BK stacker.
Tiny dancer.
Two linebackers.
To each their own. Burger, swagger, satisfaction buffet.
BK, have it your way.
I know what you're thinking. This all-new Nissan Ariya can't be an electric vehicle. You can't possibly be powerful and polished. Or be able to let go. And enjoy the... Why choose? You can have it all.
At Boar's Head, we live for delicious. For excellence that stands apart in every bite. We live for that perfect sizzle. And for perfectly melted cheese that awakens your taste buds and takes you to new heights. For experiences worth sharing and moments worth savoring. Welcome to the gateway to delicious. Welcome to the counterculture. Boar's Head. Compromise elsewhere.
People who come to Cricket stay with Cricket.
The reliability that I've had with Cricket, for me personally, is unmatched. And that's why I stick with them.
Come for the price. Stay for the service. Smile. You're on Cricket.
Illinois State has out-rebounded Bradley 34-13, leading 58-49 at 8:23 to go in the game. And our next NBC TV network production will come your way Saturday as the Murray State Racers will play host to the Missouri State Bears. Our coverage begins at 1 p.m. Central. Murray State against Missouri State on the NBC TV network. Well, I love having Murray State, Belmont, UIC coming into the conference. Terrific additions.
So Bradley is number one among six MVC men's basketball schools that rank in the top 131 of the net rankings the NCAA uses to get you in the NCAA tournament. Number one, Bradley is the highest ranked Missouri Valley team in the KenPom rankings. They are number one in rebounding margin, and they're being out-rebounded by 21.
Here's Dean.
Big basket. Still alive, man. He got an eternity left.
With shots like that, you bet they're alive. And Dean has 3 3-point field goals and his 9 points tonight. Under 8 minutes to go, second half. Kazuki out front with 10 on the shot clock. Burford is playing with 4 fouls. McChesney moving in on Mast. McChesney, and Mast got a hand on it, a shot clock violation. The ball goes back to the Braves. Let's see what they can do with it here. More shots like this will get you right back in the ball game.
They've got to come in the flow of the offense. There's a handoff from Rink Mast, and Dean buries it. Crowd's trying to get him going.
Hickman is blocked. Kendall Lewis gives the ball back to Illinois State, leading 58-52.
That is an outstanding block.
And the ball goes the other way.
We'll get McChesney offensive.
A foul is called on Liam McChesney, his second personal.
Okay, watch this block. You see how he's looking? He's reading the play. That's a secondary defender showing you great basketball IQ. Get that out of here. That is an outstanding play.
And the statement by Kendall Lewis with the block. Here's Mast. He has scored 5 tonight. From the outside, that wouldn't go down. Leons with the miss.
Stays with Bradley.
7:03 left in the second half. 58-52 Redbirds. Number 10, Connor Hickman, will inbound for the Bradley Braves. The Braves here at home are 10-1 this season, losing to Belmont last Saturday. Dean backing away from Poindexter. Hickman in the corner. Try to get the ball into Mast. Kazuki was there for Illinois State with the steal, and here come the Redbirds up by 6.
They have not been able to get the ball to Mast at all.
3-point attempt. Rolls off for Lewis.
Crowd cheers for a rebound.
They've been waiting for that. Here's Mast. Oh, the spin and the basket. That's what Bradley's been waiting for.
Talking about it in the open, his footwork has come so far since his freshman year. That's just hours in the gym working.
Kazuki, Burford on the outside. There's Knight. Kazuki facing up with Connor Hickman, 5 on the shot clock. A foul called from the 3-point line. And the foul is on Leons.
Take a look at Rink Mast. They've got to get him the ball more. Watch him in the scoring area. Takes you one way. Now he gets you on his hip, and it's over. Not going to stop the big fella down there.
Here is Seneca Knight.
That's a foul. You've got to come out under control. Crowd doesn't like it. That is a foul. Cannot close out on shooters like that.
There's 2 more for Knight. Giving Illinois State a chance to score with the clock stopped, and something they do so well, shooting free throws.
Right, 4th in the country at making free throws.
Knight, it's all 3. These 4 out of 5 from the line tonight. 17 points for Knight. He had 4 points in 27 minutes against Valpo on Saturday. Leons to Dean. Inside for Mast. Mast with the ball fake. And he hooks it in. Nine for Rink Mast.
Feed the big fella. Feed the big fella. Illinois State's going to have to double him. They're going to have to get aggressive.
And the turnover. Hickman running the floor, dishing to the corner. Montgomery. Around it goes for Dean. Air ball out of bounds to Illinois State.
Get the ball to the big guy. He's killing him down there. You can't stop him.
Well, here's the footwork you've been talking about, Cappy.
See how late and how passive the double was there? You're gonna, we call it heavy dig, light dig. Heavy dig, you're coming down. You're trying to keep him from getting a shot opportunity. That was very passive on the double, and he ate it up.
Illinois State won for the last seven from the field, leading 61-56. Getting back into their offensive flow. Burford takes the shot. Off the back iron. Here comes Duke Dean. Dean's open. He lets it fly, and it's too hard. Leons gives it up to Mast. Leons didn't have the shot. Mast was open behind him. Now Mast with the shot off the glass. He'll be on the line. 11 for Rink Mast.
Feed the big fella. He's killing him down there. Watch this. Again, if you're going to run a double at him, it was Seneca Knight. You've got to come over and you've got to give more help. He's coming over, but he's not doing anything there.
Mast is one out of four from the free throw line. Make that one out of five tonight. An 83% shooter from the line coming into the game. 61-58. Illinois State with the lead coming down to 4 minutes left.
Big possession here for Illinois State. They want to expand it again.
Poindexter scores it. He has 12.
Big
basket for Illinois State on the answer for Mast back. Basket on the other end. 63-58. And that ended a 5 minute field goal drought for Illinois State as we take a break. And we're getting down to the finish of this one coming up.
There are all kinds of products in this world. Things that make life easier or more fun. But New York Life's product is different. It's 12,000 experts whose responsibility is to be there, to guide you through the happiest and most difficult times. People who know the most valuable things in life aren't things at all. This is our product. This is what we do.
Back for another flounder fish sandwich?
And a shrimp tackle box.
Let us do the fishing while y'all enjoy our seafood that you'll love. Get them before they're gone.
You can't possibly be powerful, polished,
or be able to let go
and enjoy the open road.
Why choose?
You can have it all.
The GMC Sierra with hands-free driving. Yeah, it rocks. Step up to GMC with 2.9% APR for 5 years and no monthly payments for 90 days on Sierra light duty models.
Ooh, the Chewy app. Clumping litter, salmon pate. We have enough to splurge on catnip toys. I feel so accomplished. Pet me, please.
Great prices, happy pets. Chewy.
Metro offers MLS season pass.
On us.
What about for existing customers?
Yup.
Every match?
I bet, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Says it on the poster.
Get MLS Season Pass on us, plus unlimited 5G for $25 a line.
So halftime, this young man's a half-court shot. Bang! He goes nuts. Look at that. They got so excited. He gets this whole package of prizes. He looked like Doug Collins, the old Illinois State All-American that they named the court for. Bam! He can't believe it. Look at it. Half-court shot. Got it. How cool is that?
What a celebration.
That was awesome. Never assumed he was going to make it. And then
I'm telling you, the between action during the breaks, the entertainment's been good tonight.
Been tremendous. Tremendous. And you know who's watching the game? Our guy, Doug Collins. I was just
That's what I figured when you mentioned that. Good to have you along, Coach.
He's the best. I love that guy.
And on the free throw line, Duke Dean. Poindexter with his second foul, put Dean on the line, and Dean makes his first free throw tonight and has 10 points. He averages 10.7 a game. The other nine came on three-point field goals. 63-60 Illinois State, and Illinois State is out-rebounded. Bradley, 37-17. 19 turnovers for Illinois State, but Bradley has managed only 14 points off those turnovers. But Bradley is still in this one, down by three. Poindexter drawing the double team. McChesney for Kazuki. 10 on the shot clock. And loose ball out of bounds. Bradley takes over. Seneca Knight into the lane. He wanted a foul called on the contact.
Again, an offensive foul.
That's his first foul.
I thought they were going to get Gershon Henry there for a second.
And Henry is playing with four personals for Bradley. Malavai Leons, number 14, with the ball. Mast has scored 11 tonight. The shot from the point in the air for Connor Hickman.
And we all of a sudden are locked up at 63.
63 all. With the struggles tonight for Bradley on the boards, unable to really convert on many of the turnovers, but they've tied the score inside 3 minutes to go. Off the glass and a foul called as Seneca Knight was driving right of the lane.
Going to get Rink Mast on the foul. But here's Hickman. Makes the curl. Gets his feet set. Top of the key. Nothing but the bottom of the net.
Four fouls on Mast. Four fouls on Henry. Illinois State inbounding the ball. And that rims out. Leon's got the rebound, and he's fouled.
It's got to be a McChesney. It's got to be.
His fourth foul. McChesney. The 10th team foul. Bradley will shoot two, the remaining 249. The next foul committed by Bradley will put Illinois State at the line for a 1-1.
You know, coming off a blowout loss like the Redbirds had to Valparaiso the other day.
Oh my goodness, that was 71-51.
That was an ugly game, and they have responded. Bradley coming off having their 17 game home winning streak snapped by Belmont, 78-76. 10-2 run, by the way, for Bradley, their first lead since 30-28. But coming off that loss, you wonder, are you deflated? When you get blown out, you just, okay, flush it, let's move on. Lose, snap the streak. Maybe you come in a little flat.
11-2 the run for the Bradley Braves, leading by 265-63. Malachi Poindexter on the drive, and he is blocked by Leons.
Crowd's back into it, I'll tell you that.
Zeke Montgomery back in for Bradley with 17 on the shot clock. way out front it comes tonight. Knight spinning, now he has to look for help. Kazuki provides that. Luke with the drive, bouncing low, good catch, and the score by Kendall Lewis. He has 14 for Illinois State.
Boy, what a ball game. Dripping toward 2 minutes and we're locked up.
65 all. Hickman has 6 points. Leons. And a foul is called against Bradley. Leons with his second.
Watch this beautiful pass. And then he bobbles it, finds a way to recover.
Good hand.
Lays it in. Great hand.
Illinois State looking to break the tie. Illinois State had a 40-36 lead at halftime. We have a whistle and a timeout taken by Illinois State.
To 30.
Our players of the game, and Illinois State has had such a great effort tonight. We had several to choose from. Their presentation of State Farm, a proud partner of the Missouri Valley Conference, like a good neighbor. State Farm is there. As you see the huddle by Illinois State, and there is Brian Wardle entering his huddle with the Bradley Braves. And Bradley has had a lot to overcome in this one tonight, Cappy.
They have the rebounding differential.
And it's Seneca Knight who cracked the starting lineup in the 10th different starting lineup for Coach Ryan Peden. You see his numbers, 6 of 11 from the field, 4 out of 5 from the line, 7 rebounds in his 17 points. And Malavai Leons has scored 12. He's 3 for 3 from the free throw line. He, too, has 7 rebounds. Our players of the game presented by State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. We're tied at 65. Knight trying to find some room and lost the grip on the ball, and a foul is called as Duke Dean came away from the fray. The foul is on Knight, his second. Two shots coming up for Duke Dean. Dean made two free throws not that long ago and has 11 points tonight and looks to put Bradley back in front.
Free throws has been a huge part of this game. Illinois State, as I said, fourth in the country. Bradley has had an awful night at the free throw line. But when they've had to make one here, they just knocked it down.
Dean is trying to go 4 for 4 from the line here in the late going of this game. A minute 39 to play, and he's perfect. ...67-65, the Braves lead at home. On the weave, Luke Kazuki. He's watched by Connor Hickman of Bradley. And a shot for three goes down from the corner.
Just a massive basket. They have had an answer every time they needed to have one.
And a timeout taken with Illinois State up by one, 68-67. And check out Malachi Poindexter.
Here comes the
Kazuki looking for him. Didn't take him long to release that shot, did it?
Did not. He gave you a good little V cut, we call it. Gets himself to the 3-point stripe. He really didn't get to square his shoulders up. He just catch, turn, go, and make a play.
Poindexter tonight with 15 points. 68-67 Illinois State. You talk about a turnaround from the game on Saturday with the loss to Valparaiso, 71-51. This hasn't resembled anything like the effort for most of the game for Illinois State tonight.
Nothing. And when we talked to Coach Ryan Peden before the game, we spent some time with him. He said, I picked up the phone and I called Tim Jankovich, who used to be the coach at Illinois State.
And I got to work a game with Coach Jankovich over at Indiana
State.
Coach
Jankovich is one of my favorite guys I dealt with over all my years doing games. Just a wonderful, wonderful man.
and he said, tell me about this rivalry. What do I need to know about this rivalry? He knows about Ohio State, Michigan, where he came. And he said, people are taking it serious. In both towns, it is as big as it gets. He said, I had my guy fired up, ready to play.
Leon's number 14. There's Mast. He has scored 11. And he got an opening, but couldn't convert. Leon's ran it down. Dean's open from the point and missed it short. There's Poindexter. And down is Luke Kazupke.
I don't know if he has a cramp.
I think you're on it. I think that's
what I thought it was.
What put him to the floor. Boy, the effort tonight. As you've pointed out many times, for Illinois State, we haven't seen anybody standing around on offense at all. And that's why they have the massive rebound edge.
That rebound edge is incredible. That's the reason that they're up 68-67.
With 44.5 to go. But we were talking with Coach Beaton about the fact that you get a few efforts like this in the Valley and on the road, then pretty soon this group of players starts to feel like a team.
Yep, that's exactly right. They start to believe. Their assistant coach, Rob Judson, who used to be the head coach where I used to be the assistant, Northern Illinois.
Right.
I was there way before him. He said, we write on the board every day. Put your heart up on the rim and go up with two hands and get it. Working tonight.
Mission accomplished tonight, but the job's not done. 44.5 to go. Poindexter with the ball against full court pressure applied by Bradley. Burford playing with four fouls in the front court for Illinois State. 15 on the shot clock, 30 and counting on the game clock. And we have a foul called against Illinois State.
Wow.
On a trip.
I think they're going to get Seneca Knight.
That's his third.
Ryan Peden says, no, he did not. Let's take a look. Watch number three in black. Yes, he absolutely ran him over. 100%.
Bradley to inbound. Down by one with 27.7 to go. Let's take a look to see what the Braves have in store with this possession. Leon's inside and a steal.
They're going to get a foul.
A foul is called
Kasubi.
On Kazuki, his second, going for the steal.
Kazuki tried to get what we call half man around defensively.
Mast is 0 for his last four from the line, 1 for 5 tonight. And he missed again. This is in play at 16.3 to go to tie the game. Bradley was 5 for 13 from the free throw line, has made 6 of the last 7, and a timeout with 16.3 to go. You talk about the tension, the nervousness involved here down the stretch. But what we have seen tonight, we've seen two teams in a game that hasn't had a great deal of flow to it. But what Illinois State has been able to do to work into its offense and control the boards created a lot of chaos for Bradley.
It absolutely, they've been all over the loose balls. They've been phenomenal on the glass. We've detailed that throughout the night. And if I'm coaching in that huddle, I'm not saying a word to Rink Mast about the free throw. Guys, we tie the game up. Here's what we're going to do. And you put your defense. You do not talk. You don't want him thinking about it. Just, son, if you're a good shooter, just go up to the line. I'm thinking this in my mind. I'm not saying it to him. I don't want him thinking. I want him just reacting.
Well, in this I-74 series since 1905, we've had 49 games decided by 5 points or less, 37% of the meetings. And Bradley is 25 and 24 in those meetings.
11 of 20 for Bradley at the line. 11 of 20 Rink Mast is one of six for Illinois State at the line. 20 of 24. 20 of 24. And the rebounding is 39-19.
16.3 to go. Mast on the line for the tie. And he missed again. And a foul will send Illinois State to the free throw line with 13.8 to go. Leon's with his third foul. And the Redbirds from the free throw line tonight are 20 out of 24. McChesney, 0 for 1 from the free throw line. One and one. The bonus. Six for McChesney tonight. He averages 7-2 a game for the Redbirds.
Now, if he makes this, I don't believe you got to come down and jack up a three. I'd take it right to the rim. That's what I would do. I'd lengthen the game.
Off the back iron. Leons finds Hickman.
Now you don't need a three.
Oh, a shot for three is blocked. And a foul call. A foul call behind the arc. Oh, my.
Wow. Wow.
Kazubke with his third foul. And Illinois State up by two with 3.8 to go. And three free throws coming up.
He did foul him on the arm. Watch again. He did foul him right there on the right arm. Why you're taking that shot, I don't know.
I'm with you on that. A miss for Montgomery. His second miss from the line. One out of three tonight.
Wow, it's actually painful for me to watch this.
11 of 22 from the line for the Bradley Braves tonight. Montgomery will be shooting for the tie with 3.8 seconds to go. And a timeout taken by Ryan Peden.
It's a good timeout. Make him think about it. It's a full timeout. Make him think.
69-68 Illinois State. We've seen Bradley hang around in this one. And we talked to Coach Peden that in the steps of growing as a program, you hang around in games like this on the road, you never know. You might win one. But they set the pace tonight, Illinois State.
They did. They out-hustled Bradley. They out-hustled him. Bradley, I thought, gave you a solid effort defensively. I was stunned at their lack of flow offensively. Couldn't make some shots. Started to get a little tight, press a little bit. And then loose balls were coming up Illinois State's way, but when you get out-rebounded, the last, here we go, we just got our updated stat sheet, 40 to 20, that's unconscionable. 15 offensive rebounds, can't happen, cannot.
22 turnovers tonight for Illinois State, 10 for Bradley, and Bradley has scored 19 points off the 22 turnovers, yet Bradley can tie the game with a free throw by Zeke Montgomery right here.
Correct. What a ball game.
And it is the I-74 series to the max.
The war on 74.
Montgomery, a sophomore from Louisville, Kentucky. 5 points in 24 minutes against Belmont. The loss on Saturday. Big, deep breath.
I'm ready for overtime. Come on, kid. Knock it down.
He did.
I haven't had an overtime in a while. Let's do it. You know what overtime is? It's like you go buy a great meal at a great restaurant with your wife, and the maitre d' says, I got your dessert tonight.
That's what it's like.
That's what it's like.
I'll take your word for it. A game like this almost deserves an extra five at least.
It does.
McChesney to inbound for Illinois State with 3.8 on the clock. Let's take a look. Poindexter. Overtime.
There we go. Buckle up. Let's do it again. 69-69. Montgomery's free throw. Set up this finish to regulation. And Poindexter weaving. He had to get rid of it. Way off the mark. And now we go to overtime here at Bradley.
Classic. Classic, classic. Good crowd on hand. Everybody's wearing their respective school gear. People are watching on the NBC TV network. Everyone's locked in. Oh, get to the...
And again, I mentioned since 1905, this series, 49 games have been decided by 5 points or less, and looks like we're on the way to the 50th. We'll see, with 5 minutes up on the board. The ninth overtime game in series history. And you know what the series is in overtime? Four up and four down.
Of course it is.
I thought it'd be closer than that. My goodness. First overtime game between these two teams in this series here in Peoria since 2011. Now checking out the foul situation. McChesney has four personal fouls. So does Burford. And Sissoko has four for Illinois State. Four for Henry. Four for Mast. And three personal fouls on Darius Hanna. Three for Leons for Bradley.
Let me ask you a question. If you're coaching, do you foul rink Mast and force him to go to the line?
Boy, that is a good question. He's a much better free throw shooter than what we've witnessed tonight, where he's made just one.
But now it might be in his head. If I'm coaching against him,
that has to be a consideration.
If he's got me, you know, down on the block where he's been killing us.
Leons and McChesney for the overtime jump. Here we go, 5 minutes on the board. Illinois State led at the half by four, and now a chance to take the lead in overtime. The pick set by Lewis. Here's Knight with 17 on the shot clock. He used up the dribble. He needs some help. Provided by Poindexter. Lobbing low, and the lay-in by Lewis. Poindexter with the assist. Lewis has 16.
Well, the problem is Duke Dean, he can't guard the guy down on the baseline. That was a perceptive play. Throw it over the top and get the lay-in.
Hickman has scored six tonight. Dean with the long two-hand pass. Jashawn Henry into the lane. He muscles it off the glass. Mast missed the putback. Illinois State clearing the ball out with Kendall Lewis on the rebound. 71-69 Illinois State. McChesney short. And there's Leons for the rebound. Bradley on the attack now. Hickman. In and out. Oh, that funneled out.
Boy, one of those nights for Bradley, Illinois State, to slow it down. And now McChesney's cramping up. Right in the calf. I think these kids are laying everything out here.
Oh, we've seen it from the very opening tip of this game tonight.
Got to drink the Gatorade and just turn to the trainer and say, cramp. Those are no fun.
No, they are not. So a little help from the athletic trainer. Trying to straighten that leg and trying to ease the pain.
You ever had the ones where you're asleep?
Oh
my goodness. Those are the worst.
That's what that feels like.
Yeah. But at least you're by yourself or with
your
wife. You
can't get that foot down on the floor fast enough.
Correct. But you got to do it in front of like 8,000 people. Like, oh boy.
All right, McChesney going over to the bench to get some attention. A two-point lead for Illinois State, where this game has lacked what we call a lot of flow. It has not lacked anything in intensity. There's our foul situation.
mentioned, four fouls on McChesney, Burford, Sissoko, Mast, and Henry for Bradley.
We got to dig deep.
Wow. What a play by Knight. Knight has 19. And a 73-69 lead for the Redbirds. Bradley spreading the floor with the offense.
Going zone defense. Can't make jump shots. They're going to force you to try and make one, or you're going to have to really do a great job at hitting the seam and then kicking.
Leons off to the side and a rebound for Lewis. Lewis has been so active on both ends of the court tonight. Lewis has scored 16. 19 for Knight. Here's Knight working on Mast. And a travel. Well, let's check out our play of the game brought to you by Great Southern Bank, understanding what really matters. And on this one, we say good night.
Good night is a great way to put it. It was a big time split two defenders. Rotation is way too late. And look out below.
It was just turn and dunk. Montgomery with the pass low and a foul before Leons can get a shot away. And the foul is on Knight. Seneca has four fouls for the Redbirds. McChesney has four. Knight has four. Four for Sissoko. And here is Malavai Leons. He misses. He had gone three for three before that miss. And Leons goes after his 13th point with this one in play at 2:17 to go in OT. 13 tonight for Leons.
3-point game.
Coming off a 12-point effort against Belmont Saturday. Coming down to 2 minutes to go in the game. Jumper short for Poindexter.
Fast snatches the rebound down.
A 3-point lead for Illinois State. Montgomery, Hickman, Mast. Mast with the hook. It rolls in. He has 13.
Looks up and goes, thank you, finally. The lid is off.
Bradley's first field goal since 3:16 mark in the second half in regulation. Poindexter. Kazuki. Five on the shot clock. Kazuki is going to have to let it fly, and he's blocked. And blocked again. Boy, standing his ground. Zeke Montgomery would not allow either shot.
That was outstanding defense. I mean, just tip your cap. That is holding your ground. Don't foul. Watch how he doesn't take the bite. Don't take the cheese. Comes up with two shots.
He knew the situation. He knew what was available. Went straight up. Not one block, but two.
Correct.
Bradley down by one with 1:10 and counting. Hickman has scored six tonight. Dean for Hickman. Hickman's open. By two with 55.4 to go. I talked earlier about Hickman shooting 35% from the field, 33% from three-point range, 58% from the free throw line. He's been a sharper shooter in the second half tonight while helping run the offense.
He has. He's hit two big threes, and he had the one that rattled around we thought was down and popped out.
Boy, this takes some touch, Cappy.
There's the pass. Defender doesn't show. He shows, but he doesn't come over. He says, well, you're going to leave me open? Bang. Let's take a look at the clock. Looks at that short corner, decides I'm going to shoot it. Got it.
Well, we've seen several of those just go down and funnel back out tonight.
They're checking the clock here. 57.9 is what they will.
So from 55.4 to 57.9. The clock is reset. The referee is Kelly Self. Marcus Pettigrew and Irvin Wilson are Missouri Valley officials tonight.
Chesney's in there, fighting through cramps.
It's Illinois State, down by two, with just under a minute to go, and Luke Kazuki will inbound. Kazuki, experience with Kansas State in the 2021-22 season. He averaged 12 minutes a game for them. He was the number six prospect in the state of Missouri when he went to Kansas State out of Chaminade High School. Kazuki inbounding the ball. Knight watched by Mass. Poindexter picked up by Montgomery. Coming down to 10 on the shot clock. Poindexter with 8 on the shot clock. Looking to create something. That shot won't go. And here is Bradley with a 2-point lead on the ball and 24.2 and counting. And a foul on Kazuki, his fourth.
Really didn't get much out of their offense, and there's the ball knocked over to Connor Hickman.
It was Lewis who was called for the foul.
It just, at the most inopportune time, Illinois State just didn't get anything going to the basket, and then Poindexter took a shot, really tough shot to try and make.
And here's Dean, a miss.
Well, now you've guaranteed by missing the first one, at least, that it's a one possession game.
A 14.9 for Dean. A 3-point lead for Bradley. A 7-0 run for the Braves, putting them in the driver's seat for now.
You do not need to take a three. It lengthen the game. Attack and take it to the rim. You may get the old fashioned 3-point play.
The shot won't go for Kazuki. A rebound for Malavai Leons.
Too quick on the three for me. I've always believed inside of 8 seconds, okay, I get it. Prior to that, that was always my number, 8 seconds. Prior to that, I'm taking it right to the rack. I might get hoop and harm. Certainly, I'll take the two. I'd take it right at rink master, whoever it was that was in the ballgame at the time.
Well, that's the fifth foul on Seneca Knight. Fouling out with 11 seconds to go in overtime. 19 points for him tonight. Perfect back in. He did. 17 points, 7 rebounds. 1 steal for Knight. We have 11 seconds left in this. Bradley with a chance to add to a 3-point lead in OT. And here's Leons, 12 points, 10 rebounds, 3 block shots and a steal in the loss Saturday against Belmont. And a missed free throw. Illinois State is hoping for another one of those. But Leons hit that one for Bradley. And we have 11 seconds left And we'll take a timeout with Bradley leading 77-73 at home in Peoria.
Every sunrise offers new opportunities.
GEICO has been offering savings for over 85 years. That's longer than the buffalo wing's been around. Lips are burning.
GEICO, over 85 years of savings and service.
Let's go. Okay, lockdown, go.
Bye, boy.
It seems like only yesterday you were just a child at play. Life is brief.
You might like that one.
But when it's gone, love goes on and on.
Everyone gets a BK stacker.
Tiny dancer.
Two linebackers.
To each their own. Burger, swagger, satisfaction buffet.
And BK, have it your way.
I know what you're thinking. This all-new Nissan Ariya can't be an electric vehicle. You can't possibly be powerful and polished. Or be able to let go. And enjoy the open road. Why choose? You can have it all.
How irresistible are teasing?
Had a 10-point lead in the second half. Bradley had a 5-point lead in the first half, and Bradley is leading 77-73 in overtime with 11 seconds to go. And what can the Redbirds get out of the 11 seconds?
Well, if you race it into the front court and go right to the rim and lay it in, then foul. Possibly. It depends how quickly you can get it up the court. If not, and you're in the front court and it's 8 seconds or less, you're going to have to shoot the three ball. But either way, it's not going to tie the game for you. So I probably am telling my guys, take it right to the rim. We might get fouled and get the hoop. At the least, it's a 2-point game. We foul again and force them to make two free throws. If they don't, it's a one possession game again. I've always believed lengthen the game. If you take the three and miss, they get the rebound, it's over.
Right. And full court pressure applied by the Braves. Suzuki with the inbounds pass. Burford all the way in, spinning and scoring with 3.9 to go. There you go, Cappy.
Now you've got to foul immediately. Get a deny foul.
There it is.
Okay. Now, if they make both free throws, game's over. If they make only one, and their history tonight says they will only make one, you got a 3-point shot opportunity to tie the game and get double overtime.
Luke Kazupki with his fourth foul, and that puts Malavai Leon's on the line.
It's a tough shot with Gershon Henry all over you. It's a tough shot.
Burford scored. He has six, and then the quick foul. 2.7 on the clock with Bradley leading by two.
Leon's a good free throw shooter. You're Illinois State, you know, we just need one miss.
Kelly Self. He's taking a look at the monitor, checking the timing. While that goes on, Brian Wardle calls his team over, and so does Ryan Peden. The shot off the glass.
I think it's going to be, they're going to put.
And the inbounds pass here.
Let's see. Ball in. They're going to put a little time left here.
They will. They'll have to put a little more on the clock.
I would think. 3-2, 3-1. Funny, everyone in this building is standing. And nobody's left.
And a lot of the fans in the first two rows behind us are looking at the monitors.
Correct.
They're checking the timing.
And these four people, three dudes and this one nice young lady, they've stood the entire game. Like, guys, I'm trying to see around you.
3.3 up on the clock.
3 point.
Leon's with one more at 3.3. He made them both.
That is your ball game. Heck of a game.
Boy, this was a heck of a game tonight. What an effort for Illinois State. Time has run out. That's the game. Bradley survives 79-75. Wow.
Well, if you're Brian Warder, you're like, guys, we were terrible tonight, but we're walking out with a W. You're Ryan Peden. You're thrilled at the effort and how hard your kids played, but it's heartbreaking to lose in that fashion in this rivalry.
Oh, is it ever in this rivalry? Correct. The win goes to Bradley. Bradley improves to 14-8, 7-4 in the Valley, while the Redbirds drop to 8-14, and they in the Valley have fallen to 3-8. But what an effort for Illinois State coming off such a bad loss against Valparaiso over the weekend.
Yeah, you lose by 20 and you come roaring back in here in a rivalry game and dominate the glass. There'll be better days.
Well, Bradley is able to hang on for a 79-75 victory. And our next Missouri Valley Conference game of the week is coming up Saturday, January 28th, as Murray State will play host to Missouri State. It's the Racers and the Bears, and our coverage begins at 1 p.m. Central. What a game. Won in overtime by Bradley tonight, 79-75, our final score. Now for David Kaplan and our entire Missouri Valley Conference crew, I'm John Rooney. Good night from Peoria.
Everyone gets a BK stacker.
Tiny dancer.
Two linebackers.
To each their own. Burger, swagger, satisfaction buffet.
BK, have it your way.
This all-new Aria is an elegant EV.
Yeah, with 389 horsepower.
It's electric.
With an edge.
A ballet studio, an architecture firm, and homemade barbecue sauce. They're called small businesses, but to the people who build them, there's nothing small about them. That's why at T-Mobile for Business, you'll save more than $1,000 versus Verizon. And with Price Lock Guarantee, we'll never raise your rate plan. So you can keep your focus on toe turns and making sure the sauce is extra spicy. At T-Mobile, there are no small business.
Hey, Fridge. Hey. Did you know Auto Trader lets me shop for cars by monthly payment so I know what I'll pay before I buy?
Cool.
Was that a refrigerator joke?
Keenan, chill.
All right, just stick to making ice. I didn't mean right now.
Live sports.